Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, we're going to start by hitting Create New 3D Design. Let's rename this Crash Dummy. We are going to build with the new Sim Lab parts, so we do need to grab them. Simply enter Sim Lab and then bring them out. I like to put one in each corner just so I've got them for the rest of the lesson. So with it named and the parts out here, let me show you how this works. Bring out a sphere. I'm going to tell you to make it orange. I'm also going to tell you to take the steps down to 8 because simpler shapes work better with Sim Lab. Now I want you to do Control D on a pivot. And we're going to grab those two, choose L for a line, and we want middle, middle, and middle of the shape. Raise it up a little bit in the air. That's how the body's going to be floating. And we're going to use that same part for the head. Do Control D, lift it up on top so it's just barely above. Do Shift Squeeze to make it smaller so it looks like a head. Now we need to connect these. So we want the head to connect to the belly. We want the orange one to connect to the head. And then on this connector, let's click down on it. And we want it to connect to the head. And we want the orange connector to connect to the belly. If you go to SimLab real quick and hit play, we have got them both there, but they're connected up and down. Let's reset this real quick and try it one more time. I want this one to connect to the body. And I want the orange one to connect to the ball. And I believe when we hit play, that should fall. That's what I was hoping for. Pause, reset, and let's go back and add the limbs. It is so cool, friends. All we do is grab the head. Do Control D, move it out with a shift nudge, and then we're gonna shift squeeze to make it smaller. I like size 8, maybe size 7. And then we want the blue tip to rotate 90 degrees. We can grab that leg now and stretch it out. Pick whatever size you want. And then I'm going to just use the nudge to get it in place. I'm going to do control down and move it over where the left leg would go. I think that is pretty nifty. As I look at it from a side, I think that is right where I want it connected. Now I just double check the connections. So this one is connected to the middle. If we click on the orange one back there, it is connected to the shape, and we can do that same trick to grab two of them. Control D, shift nudge, and we have got an extra click in both legs. We're going to do Control D again, and this is going to be an arm. I do want to rotate it 90 degrees. Remember, if you stay inside the shape, it's 22.5 degrees at a time. We could use the handle to lift it or the arrow keys as you move those two parts into place. I think that is going to be fantastic. I'm grabbing those two, Control D, shift nudge to get to the other side. This time we want to use the awesome flip command. Now the blue tip is aimed this way. We can select them again and nudge them into place. Friends, you have just built a tiny crash test dummy that you can put in your vehicles. Let's give it a quick test to make sure everything's working like we expect. When we hit play, bingo, he falls down, and when you hit him, he can move in every direction. Let's do one silly thing with our crash test dummy first, though. I'm going to search for stairs. When you find the stairs, of course, bring them out, rotate them, check those measurements. I'm going to say that I want several levels. There's 12 levels. That should be plenty. I am going to make it wider, and if we move this out of the way, we can lift up our little crash test dummy, put in our stairs, and of course, once you've got it set up, the fun part is to go to the Sim Lab and just see what kind of action you get. I do want to take that one and make it static. Let's hit play. Oh, we lost a leg. That was not what I was anticipating. See if I can knock him off there with the banana. You can see he's actually got a leg connected. Let's back up and mod him super quick. Once again, pause, reset, and I want to connect this to the body. Let's click that connector, and I want to connect this here. One more time, friends, let's hit play. Now we have got our feller falling like he's supposed to. Once again, we can back it up, watch it again as we experiment with our silly little crash test dummy. I'm gonna back out and let's double check a couple things. If we click on the connector, see the angle of limit? Right now it was limited at 30. You can bump that up so it can move more degrees in every direction. These are things you can play with to make it look the way you want. Friends, I'm of course looking forward to the mods that you make. This is the little car design that will be coming up soon. I'm gonna hide the connectors so you can see how our little dude is sitting inside. I just added a hole and the bucket seat that is one of my tutorials as well. And of course, friends, the fun part is we get to check it out. If we go to Sim Lab, of course, you do need to wait for everything to snap into place. Some of the parts have been made static so that they stay where they're supposed to be. There are the parts already. Let's hit play and watch them crash. Friends, that's why we're making this. So much fun to explore, test, and just see what we can build with the awesome Tinkercad Sim Lab. And once again, if you want to make this public for the world to see, don't forget you can click on settings. Always make the background a little bit more cool. I'm going to make mine tan. I'm going to shut off the grid. And then you can click back here to the Tinkercad workspace. Click on your properties. Give it a good name. Of course, in the properties, you'll note mine has a tutorial coming soon. Also, you can check out the new shares by clicking that link. Finally, these are other ways you can reach me. Once again, if you add tags, people can search for your cool projects. And if you add the tag HLMT23, I search that tag every day. And of course, when I see your cool designs, I will give you a reaction. Finally, make your design public. Prove you're not a robot. And then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some awesome skills. Lastly, hit save changes. Friends, as I wrap up, I do want to take a moment to remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. As you can tell, I've got a page dedicated to Tinkercad with tons of amazing lessons. Down below, you can find the day one favorites, the useful starters, and the Tinkercad essentials. Friends, below that, you'll find the sweet built-in messaging tool. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. I do also need to highlight the link to the Tinkercad Community Discord. As you can see, there are a boatload of members, and it is a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.